Well, hey there, everybody. I'm Jack, and this is Raw Tropical Living. Thanks for joining me today. Man, it's January 10th when I'm shooting this video. It's hard to believe how time goes by that we're already 10 days into January. It seems like we were 2 weeks out from Christmas, just like that. I'm telling you, that time goes by too fast, and it goes by faster and faster. When you get to my age, that shit's just going round and round and round. Today I want to talk about my raw food diet in 2019 and what I'm eating. Guys, I do videos every day, so if you aren't already subscribed to the channel, please go down and hit that red subscribe button now, then click on the little bell and check send notifications so you'll stay subscribed to the channel. Wearing some more of our gear this morning. Man, this thing is comfortable. A friend of mine in Spain was wearing hers this morning, this lightweight shirt with a little hood on it. And got another beanie on today. Go check it out. Always got the store down in the description below, RawTropicalLivingGear.com. So what am I eating in 2019? Are there any radical departures? Am I changing philosophies? What am I doing? Nope, just always tweaking, filling in the holes, experimenting a little bit, working on, you know, just moving down the road, moving down the path. My body just kind of lets me know what direction we're going to go in each, you know, every 6 or 8 months or sometimes a year. We just decide, all right, let's do this. One thing I'm really trying for more in 2019 is variety. Because, I mean, you know, I can eat uber simple, and I don't think there's anything wrong with eating uber simple. But also, too, I think, you know, instead of just eating the same things over and over and over, I'm going to try to work a little bit more variety into what I'm eating. Really just kind of like a little tweak here, a little tweak there, getting a little bit more of this. Yeah, I wasn't paying attention to this. I'm getting the oranges. I was so heavy on bananas for a while, but I'm getting the oranges regularly again, and I am having a glass of juice in the morning. That's almost always my first go-to in the morning is 32-ounce glass of fresh squeezed orange juice. Took a little while to ripen, but I got some mangoes down in Pensacola at the Asian market last week and finally ripened and cut to this morning. They're good. So, not just all bananas all the time, all smoothies, all ice cream, if I can do more. So far today I've had 32 ounces of orange juice. Then I cut up two of these mangoes. They were big, good bit of mango, probably had about 3 or 4 bananas with that. And I'm thinking probably, what am I going to get the next meal? But the next meal will most likely be a green smoothie. I'm trying to just think of little components that I'm focusing on. I'm using chia seeds regularly, you know, because they're a good source of, I'm just kind of trying to make sure, you know, like I say, I can be just haphazard sometime, and then I can go on these kicks where I'm like, okay, well, let's make sure we're getting a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Make sure the chia seeds are great for calcium. They're good ratios on the omega-3 fats. So I'm trying to get in a habit of putting a couple of tablespoons of those in every day, in my smoothies. What else? I don't have any Brazil nuts right now. I'm trying to find some Brazil nuts so I can get back to do it, you know, having maybe a Brazil nut or two a day, not very many. For the selenium, I'm trying to use pumpkin seeds more, just like a small handful of pumpkin seeds, maybe 2 or 3 times a week. For the zinc, What else am I using? I'm putting some dulse in my salads, and I'm putting some dulse in my smoothies as well, just for a little bit of iodine. And you know, all this stuff we'll talk about out there, somebody will say, well, you don't absorb this, you don't absorb that. You know, we do the best we can. I'm not going to get into these like deep discussions on what the body is absorbing and what it's not. We just try to do the best we can. And that's, like I say, that's what I'm focusing on this year, variety, and not just eating bananas all the time. Okay, let's just do what I'm going to eat in a day video, since I haven't eaten it already. 32 ounces of orange juice this morning. Like I said, 2 mangoes and 3 or 4 bananas for the second meal. Here very soon, I'll probably make myself a green smoothie. Green smoothie will have bananas, kale, spirulina, tiny bit of cacao for flavor, and the chia seeds. Let's see, after that, I'm sure there's going to be some ice cream today at some point. It's hard to get through a day without ice cream. I don't know how much, though. There may not be a big meal because I've got something planned for dinner, too. I'm actually making something, which I haven't done in a while. Just haven't been inspired. Keeping my fingers crossed. I've been feeling a little bit better every day. So now I'm a little bit more inspired to do more than just, like I say, slug down bananas. So for dinner, or late afternoon, or whenever I decide to make it, I'm gonna make some. I'm gonna spiralize some zucchini, really good Italian zucchini I got, and I'm gonna make a marinara sauce. But I like to throw an avocado in my marinara, so I'm gonna make just a nice big plate of pasta marinara sauce. Let's see what else. I want to get more celery in. I bought some celery today. I'll probably do a banana and celery smoothie tomorrow. I see everybody's doing the morning celery juice right now. I like my orange juice in the morning, but I think I might start doing a celery juice in the afternoon. Let's see. And if I don't get started early enough in the day, or if I just don't get enough in, sometimes I get to that last meal of the day and I'm a little calorie deficient, or either I don't have as much, I didn't have as many mangoes or whatever. But when I eat cooked, I've been eating sweet potatoes. Sweet potatoes to me are the closest thing, as far as how my body feels to the raw. And like I say, I'm not gonna miss calories anymore. I'm coming out of this winter about 165. I'm not gonna be Mr. Skinny Dude emaciated anymore. So yeah, that's what I do. And I just keep it real clean. It's nothing, it's super, super, super simple. I had it, did I have it last night? Or I had it the night before last. I just steamed about four big sweet potatoes. And then I steamed, big helping of what am I trying to say? Brussels sprouts. Man, words go out of my head sometimes. I just had that, and I put it in a big bowl. I mash it up. I put a little hot pepper sauce, clear hot pepper sauce with Bragg's apple cider vinegar. But yeah, that's just some good grinding. If like I say, I'm not gonna miss my calories. And sometimes I get to the end of the day and I just haven't gotten enough food in. Which also brings me a point too as to why I start eating in the morning. Listen, I don't know how anybody else's body works out there, and I'm not going to worry about that anymore. But a lot of these things people say, well, you should try this, you should try that. Dude, I've tried it. Not that I've necessarily made a habit of trying it, but I have to start eating early and I have to eat often. I don't know who these people out there that are eating 3 or 4 bites a day and they're not gaining or losing weight. I mean, my weight plummets, which is also too, I can kind of look back on some mistakes I made last summer when I was drinking all that watermelon juice. The watermelon juice wasn't a mistake. It was just that I entertained myself. I drank, I enjoyed my watermelon juice a lot of times up until 10, 11. First time I would actually eat during the day was about noon. And then, I just progressively, I would miss a meal here, or I'd miss some calories here, what I'm used to getting. So those are just some of the things I'm adding in. I'm going to add, but variety is the key. It's not those particular things. I was at the market this morning and it didn't fit in. I started to, I may have second thoughts on that. I might be sorry I didn't, but that just means I'll make the pasta again later this week. I almost got mushrooms. I love getting portobello mushrooms, chopping them up, marinating them a little bit, and letting them sit in the windowsill all day, and then putting them in a recipe. So, yeah, it's just getting more variety this year. Getting more variety, trying to fill in those gaps. I've already told you I supplement B12, I supplement vitamin D3. I'm going to try to do a better job when warm weather rolls around of getting sun this year, but it just gets so oppressively hot here in the summer that it is not pleasant at all to be outside. You're just sweating and breathing heavy, and it's just nasty. But yeah, that's it. That's it. I'm just going to kind of stay the course in 2019 and eat. As I always advise people, there are no tricks, there are no gimmicks. I'm not gonna come out with some little gimmicky thing. I just keep eating and I keep trying to learn and try to expand my knowledge. So anyhow, that's what I'm doing. Hope you guys enjoyed this one today. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up, and I'll see you guys again tomorrow. Peace.